Happy Thumbs Gaming. We shall.
What is up, everybody? It's me, HTG Brian, here with another LEGO Batman 3 video. This one's for level 2 story Breaking Bats. And we're going to get the Breaking Bats trophy achievement for completing the level. Our collectibles are rather slim pickings, as we will be coming back and nailing all of those in our free play. The true hero requirement for studage is 170,000 studs. So we actually fall short of that, but hey, we'll come back once we get our multipliers. So right off the bat, we're going to go ahead and switch into our sensor suit. And we're going to look around and we're going to see a couple things that need fixing. First off, there is a left and a right, also a center-based area that needs to be moved. Just hit the icon indicated. For us, it was square. And then right in the middle, there's a button. So I double-checked all the arrows, and there was nothing there. So once we get it all, it'll go ahead and open up, and you can see it's like boop, 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 and it gives us power to something. So over on the left-hand side, we will see it opened up a little, another little grapple hook there. And look at this, we got ourselves another suit token. This one's for the power suit. I almost said another power suit token. This one's one of my favorites. It blows up everything. I'm going to kick Robin in the face a couple times just because. Actually, I didn't mean to do that. Sometimes you just get button happy and it just happens. All right, so pressing and holding the square button on the PlayStation. I assume it would be B on the, I guess it would be X on the old Xbox-a-rooney. It goes ahead and fires a missile, and then wait for it, boom. All right, blow up all that stuff. It's going to give us access to, well, eventually it'll give us access. But what it did there is it kind of freed up some stuff. We built up the old, that. Spin it to win, and once you get the ladder all the way to the top, it actually turns into a bridge. Whee! All right, so... hey, if you guys are here looking for free play stuff, well, come back for the free play videos. We're going to be working on those as soon as possible. More than likely, they are already up for you. But in the event that this is a fresh released video, it might be a wee bit still. Look at this. We got Arthur rolling around. Oh, beep, beep. Denied. That's right. You don't have high enough access. You got to be pimping. All right. Batman, come on, you gotta turn into your security suit here. Nope, I'm pressing the wrong button, so my bad on that. I'm still kind of noobing it up. It's been a while since I've played Batman. And here we go. We're gonna go ahead and sneak in. We gotta actually go invisible, not use our super awesome new sense there. All right, so this gets a little tricky in here. At least it did for me, and I have a nice little clean edit coming up here that'll kind of save me. But essentially what you need to do is you need to go invisible with the security suit, which I've already done. Go into this area where I am. Now where I'm standing right now, we need to switch into the power suit, and we need to blow that up with one of our bombs. So you have to press and hold to drop a bomb, and I guess that's kind of what it tells us right there. And I started to right there, and then I switched. So, fail. I did kick the little token container over, and it does warn me and says, hey, you need to be Robin for this one. So, that's when we went and actually tried to drop a bomb over here. So, we're going to switch back over into the power suit and press and hold the circle or B button to make that happen. And then it'll go ahead and blow it up. So, once that happens, you can flip the lever there. Of course, you got to wait for those flashing pieces to disappear. But it will allow you to, it turns it off. Turns the little scanner off, so now we don't have that denial. And we can bring Arthur, or in this case, Robin in. And we'll go ahead and grab the the techno suit. Oh, wait, not that kind of techno? All right. Well, anyways, it was worth a shot. I warned you I'd break into song. All right, so we're going to go ahead and go over to the panel, and it's kind of guiding us right to it. But once we get up here, I was honestly a little confused on what I was supposed to be doing here. I just kept pressing the button, honestly, and eventually it worked. And it wasn't until the end that I was like, oh, wait a minute, it's supposed to be in the middle, probably the color. So it looks like you have to wait for it to cycle for the color to be in the middle. Once you hit the right color, then bam. Hey, we're going to actually head up this elevator and go into a cutscene. So as per usual in the story, I'm going to shut my yap. I'll be back.
Hmm. Some kind of spaceship. Its composition suggests it came from outside the solar system.
Maybe we should contact Martian Manhunter to check it out from the watchtower.
Yeah. Go contact him on the Justice League communicator.
Oh. Okay. Sure. Oof. We're doing my idea!
How wonderful.
Hey! You change your mind about my idea? Are we going out?
But sir, your dinner. But it's your favorite, and I cut the crust off.
I don't think he's mad about the food.
Master Bruce, I say, whatever's come over him.
I don't know, Alfred. Watch out!
All right, so Batman has clearly gone cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. And it's up to Boy Wonder and handy old Alfred to go ahead and save the day. Now, I want to make note that there is a mini kit available in story mode, and it starts right here with this globe. It's kind of dark, but it's actually a blue globe. And if you smash all three of the globes, you can see the number two is right there on the right-hand side. I'm actually going to smash it in a minute. And for whatever reason, I actually did not see or notice number three. So I know it's available. Dougie made note that it is available in story mode. So I can guarantee you that. But other than that, we're just going to pretty much smash and grab everything in the area. And I want to make sure I spread the love here a little bit, so I switched on over to Alfred. Da-da-da. All right. It's clearly not breakable. I need to move on now. Now, one cool thing about Alfred is he can use his little platter as a guard for flames, and he can actually put out some flames and walk over other ones. So that's pretty handy. We find that out here in a second. To be completely honest with you, my son also got this game today, and he was playing it downstairs on his PS3. And I came down there and saw it, and he showed me that. I was like, wow, that's pretty cool. Like, I didn't know that to begin with, but he taught me something today. So, moral of the story, make sure you pay attention to whoever's teaching, because you could learn something. All right. So, you can see here, we got some more stuff to smash up on this upper platform. Whee! Watch out for that last step. It's a doozy. And what we're going to need to do is switch on over to Robin. You could tell that, because it's kind of indicating by a flashing Robin headshot up there, which is, I don't know if you know this little fun fact, that headshot's actually what started Robin's modeling career. No, I'm just kidding, it really didn't, but, oh, he's going batty, 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 boom, 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 literally, boom, 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 look at that. So we're gonna have to rinse and repeat this method of getting to Batman and then drawing in his attention and being swarmed with bats and then trying to shoo them away while his explosives go big bada boom. All right, well, there's a nice little funny moment. I told you sometimes I break out into song, and there's one coming up, and I know it because there's a part that's just, you'll see. It's just, if I didn't do it, anywhere near my age bracket, you're going to understand. If you're a little bit younger, you might not get it. But all right, use Alfred to go ahead and trudge your way over those flames. Once you do, it'll cue kind of a little mini scene here where Batman shoots his rockets and blows up some silver stuff, which actually works out fairly well for us. A couple of bouncing bits. We'll go ahead and, well, knock them over the edge. No, that's not what you want to do. You want to build them up. Luckily for us, it worked. All right, so this is where it gets tricky. We're going to actually need Robin to go ahead and perform the next action over here. But how on earth are we going to do that? We got to get Robin through the flames. Oh, wait for it. There's some bouncing bricks we walked right by that'll build up the flame and start the car wash. Oh yeah, at the car wash. Terrible singing, but hilarious if you get the pun. All right, or I guess it's not really a pun. It is kind of punny, but it's not really a pun. It's funny. All right, moving along. It's been a long day. We're going to go ahead and switch over to Robin in the techno suit. Get our oomps on. And use our remote control. It's pretty cool. It's one of the coolest things I've seen so far. And I don't know that about you. It looks like a pumpkin out there, kind of. Pumpkin, a faceless pumpkin. But it'll spin around and actually give us access to a grapple hook, which we can swing up onto. And I tried to make my way over to that platform. And I kind of got lucky and made it behind there, but my luck quickly ran out. So speaking of run out, let's run out and over to where Batman is and cue this next little scene here. Uh-oh, we've gone batty again. Big bada boom. All right, so two down. And lucky for us, we know the formula that usually includes the number of three, or the rule of three, as we call it. And there we go. We got it. We're knocking some stuff down. We're going to... I got confused. I'm trying to build bricks here. I swear I am. I'm trying to hold the circle. But the circle button happens to also be the button that triggers my little remote control. So here we go again. I'm trying to build these bouncing bricks because I'm standing on them and they're bouncing. But all right. Third time's a charm. Here we go. Rule of three yet again. All right. So this provides a nice little screen here, which we can access with our suit. So make sure you stay in that. Get your rave on. Oh, I keep forgetting. It's not that kind of techno suit. If he breaks out glow sticks by the end of this, I swear, though, we're going to be fighting if that's the case. All right, so here we go. Batman's upstairs. He's planted one more bomb on that giant, looks like a telescope. And he kind of wasn't expecting that bada boom to be so close. All right, look at that. We get the illumination suit. So this one's pretty cool. It's basically like you're a big neon sign. You charge it up at these little charge stations. And there may be some other use to it, but at this point, we're going to charge it up and it'll illuminate hallways and darkness. Think of it like Gandalf or a wizard in like Lego or Hobbit, or Lego Lord of the Rings or Hobbit. Oh, there's the third globe. I did see it. That's right. So if you got all globes and you wanted to get it, booyakashow, there you go. Here you go. It tells you too, the illumination suit lights up dark spaces for limited times. All right, so we're going to walk into this hallway and blow up some stuff or pull our cord here and then go into a cutscene. Oh, yeah.
Bat computer, emergency defense protocol code SJB99.
Protocol verified. Non-lethal utilization of intruder. Identify threat.
Batman. You won't hurt him, right?
Affirmative. Stun missiles only. Targeting computer locked. Initiating defense procedure.
Bat computer! Disable the Batmobile! Oh, darn, too late.
What was that? Oh, darn, too late. That was just downright silly. All right, so this is actually the part where I walked in on my son playing, and he showed me where the... or how you could use Alfred to walk over fire, so it was pretty handy. And there's also another mini kit that I'll point out when we get there, but as you know already, we are going to save all of our actual mini kits until the free play series. So I attempted more than once to destroy that, but it was clear that I could not break it. We're going to go all the way down into this lower level and break everything in sight. Chaw, 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 chaw. Make sure you collect your studdage along the way. Gotta be honest, though, you're not gonna probably get anywhere near the requirement, which is 170,000. Like, I usually break pretty much everything in sight. I may have missed a thing or two along the way. I even find a purple stud that's kind of hidden, and I'm still nowhere near it by the end. I did die quite a few times, though, too, and that does remove a handful of studdage, so. All right, so the goal here really is there's a little dark, cavernous area on the left-hand side of our walkway, as you can see on the top left side of the screen there. We do need to drop in there and light it up with our illumination suit, so we are going to need Robin, and lucky for us, there's a charge station right here, so we'll go ahead and hit the button indicated to switch on over, and then we'll get our charge on. So yeah, there's a blue stud or two back there as well, so I feel like I did pretty good finding what was available. It seems like you're going to need a multiplier in order to get the actual requirement. All right, so here we go. We're going to use this over here and blow up all these missiles. This cannot be safe. I don't care if you got an illumination suit or not. You can see what you're doing. If I could see I was knocking a bunch of rockets around, I'd probably stop. But it's actually needed for this. You're going to have to bust that up. It will reveal some bouncing bricks that you can build and use. Now, this is where the minikit is. If you want to use Alfred, you can actually dig in the left corner over there where it's all dark and scurry. And apparently you dig up a minikit. That's the rumor I was told anyway. So try and prove me wrong. No, I'm just kidding. Try it. See if you get it. Just remember, though, you got that one, and don't grab that one when you come back in free play, because you may end up with an extra mini kit, which, you know, probably won't, but could cause some issues for you. All right, so we used this techno suit again to go ahead and flip the switch. And the Switch is actually going to very slow and casually build this bat boat here. And lucky for us, it doesn't get destroyed along the way, nor do we. But I would say that if it sped it up, I wouldn't be mad at it at all. All right, it's another blue one out here. We go out there and we see that, in fact, we can actually jump out onto the bat boat and use it. And once we do, we're going to get our pew, pew, pew on and shoot at it. Because for some unknown reason, as soon as we get in to the bat boat, it drops its shield over there on the Batmobile. So, again, the rule of three. As you can see, we took about a third of his health off by blasting. So we're going to go ahead and, well, unfortunately, he blows up our bat boat. So we got to move on. But thankfully for him, he cleared our path for us. So we're going to follow the yellow brick road all the way up and around these. And yeah, I'm going to go ahead and get my, I'm going to charge it up real quick, except for I'm not, I got the wrong suit on. All right, I didn't want to look like a moron any more than I already have. I usually noob it up a little bit, and there's always that one video that's like super noobage, so. Let's save it for a later date, because I got lots of levels ahead of me, so. All right, so I walked through the fire with my platter. And got up top and just simply built the bricks up there, which this cool little robotic arm comes and uses an extinguisher. A little bit of excessive use of resources here. I mean, I'm not sure why I couldn't have just picked it up and put out the flames, but then I would have had to sing a song. We didn't start the fire. It was always burning. I usually bust that one out. That's just, it's a given. I'm a 80s kid. I know, that's old. That dates me back way, way back, huh? That's like dinosauric almost to some of yous out there. All right, yeah, so we're going to get our smash on. There's obviously lots of breakable items here and plenty of studdage to be found and pilfered. So yeah, I'm not sure why Alfred decided to go and just give the old backhand to Robin there, but it seemed appropriate after it was done, I guess. All right, like I said, smash and grab everything on the platform here. I thought for sure there was a shining element over one of the boxes on the left. I thought for sure it was going to be a mini kit, but it wasn't. It's kind of deceiving, I won't lie. A lot of these, the mini kits, you know how they have that, they spin around and they have that illumination with the light shining through. Well, I thought for sure that's what it was, but nope, it was like, fooled you. All right, I did a backside 180 with my remote control to prove that I am better than Alfred at remote control cars. And we'll go ahead and make our way down and around. Like, at first I thought I'd already been down here, but clearly I had not been. And we're going to use our grapple over on the far end here to go ahead and, I guess, make ourselves a bridge. Spam, 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 bam, spam that button. All right, walk across. And, yeah, keep smashing. I mean, there's no reason to stop. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Or I guess if it ain't broke, make sure you break it. And I was a little, I thought for sure I was going to walk the lines here and potentially end up getting this mini kit on accident. I usually will start over. I know that sounds silly, but I try to avoid at all costs to get those so that I can get them all in one fails or one great swoop, not failed swoop. But there you can see it floating around and I was kind of playing with it. I was like, is that door open? Can I actually get in there? Like, look at me thinking about, like, oh, gosh, should I try? So I try to get in this, and I'm like, oh, what about this? Can I get, no, can't get in here. And I'm like, oh, I just better bag it. Forget about it. Forget about it. So I just rolled on. And remember I mentioned I find a Poiple stud? Well, if you make your way all the way out and around down here, and I don't think you need to. I think this was a little excessive. But over here on the far right side, you can smash and grab. That's right, a Poiple stud. Oh, you see it float. There it went. Oh, trust me, it was there. All right, so now that we have pretty much done absolutely nothing other than grab some studdage, let's go ahead and make our way back around and figure out what needs to go down. You can see there's some free playage up on the roof there, some silver items, I guess. Well, no, I was going to say, I guess I can get it. I got Batman in his power suit, but clearly Batman's gone batty right now. So we'll go ahead and save that for free play as well. Yeah, see, look, I'm pushing it. I'm doing pretty good, but I'm still only I'm not even to 80k yet on the stud. So clearly multipliers will be necessity. All right, so we make our way back on over here, and once we get up and around, we actually discover that we had totally walked right by something right in front of us. Yep, that's right. See that thing right in the middle? Yeah. We're supposed to, we're supposed to interact with it. So we'll walk out there. Oh, look at that. Got to smash it, and it will provide us the last bricks to build up. Now, quit playing remote controlsies. All right, look at that. Bat bike. Serve it up. Ding. All right, now we're talking, except for we're not. Where are we going to ride this thing? We got nowhere to go. I got Doc in my head going, where we're going, we don't need roads. Look at that, I just got my blast on. One more third knocked off, and he blasts us to the higher level up there. Also giving us access via some random ladder that was pretty nicely placed there. All right, so we can see we've got a bunch of bricks to build some stuff. Let's build up that little Robin Hobbit hole. That's right, it's a Robin Hobbit hole. Maybe we should just call them Robbit holes? I don't know. I don't think that'll stick. It sounds a little weird. But we also notice there's a bunch of yellow, green, and red bricks down on the ground back there. So we're going to probably have to get our slurpage on with Robin here, too. So, all right, we got our little remote control car. If you press the icon indicated while standing in front of it, you will zoom right on through to the other side. All right, I messed up. I shouldn't have done that. You don't do that either. Learn from my mistake. Don't press the triangle button or circle when it's not needed, or for that matter, Y or B. Yep, not leaving anybody out. All right, so look at us surfing through, catching the high waves. Woo-hoo! Realistically, we need to go to a terminal and activate it, which I was standing right next to it, but it didn't show me any kind of icon, but there we go. Spam, spam, spam. Oh, look at that. It throws you a loophole. You got to hit square at the end. But the bridge will then present itself. Now we have access to get over there. Make sure, don't forget about old Alfred. I thought for some reason I might be able to put out those flames permanently and do something there, but nope. Oh, you know what? It looks like there was another purple stud right there. I'm pretty sure if you go back, there is a purple stud right there in those little rocks in the Kona. All right, clearly some building bricks. We're going to build those up, and I need to learn the name of this thing. I can't remember what it's called. It clearly has to do with the hazard suit, and it's clearly where you put all the bricks. Contamination something? I don't know. I'll have to go back and read or listen, watch, pay attention, I guess. All right, it has a 25 brick Lego brick requirement. There we go. Haha. Fooling myself. I told you guys it's been a long day. All right, we got those inserted. We're ready to move on now, and it's queued up some supercomputer here. Walk up and hit the icon indicated. Beep boop boop beep boop boop. All right, look at that. You didn't know we were going to play some Tron, did you? All right, this is really pretty simple, although it looks way cool and looks like it might be a lot more challenging than you would think. It's not. You just run up and you go and basically stand on the little button there. Whee! I would imagine as the game goes on, if they continue this little area, I'm sure that, it's kind of like the hacking from Lego the Movie, or the Lego Movie. But, I would imagine we'll see a few of these along the way, and they will probably get a little bit more difficult. But, again, it uses the rule of three. So we'll jump up here and hit that one, and this one, it moves. I certainly wouldn't call it difficult. I tried to come up on the backside. Giggity. Did not work. So I had to come around to the front. So here we go. All right. Make our way up and around. Really just all about timing. And third one's a charm. Oh, yeah. All right. That'll take us into a cutscene. And, of course, we'll see you on the other side of that.
Before Master Bruce decides to destroy it.
Danger! That will be an armor breach!
even do that? I've never seen Bruce act this way. Gotta be something messing with his mind.
I do hope Master Bruce isn't upset that I used the Batmobile for grocery shopping.
All right, so yeah, this is a little weird. It definitely reminds me of, I don't know, maybe the Sandman incident in Marvel, perhaps. Very similar by nature, very different by story, I guess. But again, one more time, the rule of three applies, and we're gonna need to go ahead and basically just live long enough for him to throw these bricks out. He throws three different times, he throws bricks out. You need to build them up. Each time you have to do something a little different by spamming a button. Try not to get knocked off like I did. It's pretty hard being as big of a noob as I am sometimes. But eventually you'll get that button spammed enough and it'll spin around and it'll present him and he'll be weak and you'll have to go in and pow him right in the kisser. Now hopefully you won't have this incident with the camera like I did. It kept killing me. I don't know why it zoomed in like that. It does it again in a minute, just kind of a funny angle, so to speak. But, yep, once I revive myself and get over there, I punch him right in the mouth. And then we got to just kind of, like I said, stay alive. He throws like a right hook and then a left hook. And then he does the old double slam. And then we move on to some bad breath halitosis nation stuff. Oh, we got to run over and get involved in the battage. And, usually, once he does that, he offers up some bricks. Nope, one more slam. He's going to dump him on the right side next. I think it's after this one. Yeah, I got all slow motion there. Oh, I was wrong. It's right in the middle. Build him up all quick. Boy, my preview window's getting a little jumpy on me. It's lagging a little bit. The editor's lagging. All right, so this one, you got the green and red switch. Obviously, go green for go. And get up on in there, give him a little smackaroo again. So remove yet another heart, and it'll knock us back one more time. Get in for that final strike here in a second. All right, he's swinging. You know the bricks are coming when it slows down, gets all matrix on you. Not happening yet, it's not happening yet. Oh, bad breath time. Spam that button, get out of it, and come on, bricks, come on, big bricks, no whammies. Bam. All right, there they go on the far right side. It looks like Christmas, red and green. Build them all up, and guess what? It's a boom box. Boom, 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 boom. All right, and that'll, of course, take us to a final cutscene, and then we'll discuss what we found and didn't find in the total screen. So yeah, you got to go in and smack him one more time, of course. Who would miss the opportunity to smack Batman around? I know I sure wouldn't.
Batman, wait, it's me, Robin, you know, Tim Drake. We're a team, remember? We're supposed to fight the bad guys. Please, I'm your friend.
Sorry.
Back computer. Cancel defense protocol.
Protocol canceled. Yep.
But just so we're clear, I'm Batman. I don't need friends.
You sure? I mean, how else did I get through to you if it wasn't for your emotions?
Emotions had nothing to do with it. One of the panels in the Batmobile shorted out. The electrical charge must have counteracted the mind control.
I'm pretty sure it was my speech.
It was a good speech, sir.
It wasn't a speech. The question is, who was trying to control my mind, and why?
Hey! No pictures, please.
We're in. Don't worry, Croc. That strength of yours will come in handy once we're on the Watchtower. With the power of its binary fusion cannon, I can hold the world to ransom and demand to be made president.
But Lex, baby, being president is so last year.
Grundy-star!
Old Solomon Grundy is definitely not lacking in the eating department, is he? All right, Breaking Bats trophy achievement is now ours. We have also unlocked free play for level 2, or should I say free play. As we already mentioned, we fell extremely short on the studs for this. I'm not even sure. I think we just barely got over 50. Yep, there we go, 56%. And we did not, I don't even think we saw or heard Adam running around. We had opportunity, a couple mini kits, chose to pass them up so that we could get them all in our free play videos. We did play as Alfred, so of course that character token unlocks. We did complete the level, so we get one gold brick, but that's pretty much it. So slim pickings in the story mode. Like I said, it's all about cutscenes and completing the levels, and all the collectible stuff will come in the free play. So that's going to go ahead and wrap up Lego Batman 3 Beyond Gotham Level 2 Breaking Bats. I wonder what that's a reference to. Hey, if you guys found this video entertaining or maybe slightly helpful, why don't you drop by one of our social pages and say hey. You can find the links down below in our video description. And yeah, it makes it nice and easy for you. So really, you have no excuse. But yeah, like I said, why don't you guys head on over to Facebook, Twitter, comment, vote, subscribe down below. Of course, we got Twitch rocking now too, so come check us out streaming over there. We also have Instagram and a G+ page, and of course, HappyThumbsGaming.com is the home of all of our product and game reviews. So come check us out over there. We'd appreciate it, and we even have a boosting forum. It doesn't really apply for this game, but in future games, you might find the need for a boosting partner. So come help us kickstart that off, and yeah, as always, until next time. Yeah, science, bats!